everyone and welcome back. My name is Yeshim. In today's lesson, we're going to look at the language that we can use to show our agreement to positive and negative statements. My example sentence is, I'm happy. This is a positive sentence. The negative alternative is, I am not happy. The word not makes the sentence negative. I'm not happy. So if your friend says, I'm happy, and you want to show that you're happy, just like your friend, what would you say? There are different alternatives. One is, I'm happy. I'm happy too. It's quite easy because you copy the original statement like a parrot, exactly as it is, no changes. I'm happy too. Add the word too. I'm happy. I'm happy too. It's quite easy, isn't it? I'm happy too. Another alternative, again, this is quite easy. You could say, me too. Me too means I'm happy too. Very easy. Now, there is a third alternative. I will come back to this in a while. And that's what I want to talk about in more detail today. How about if the statement is negative? How do we show that we agree to the negative statement? This road here is sometimes very noisy, and I'm not happy with it. I'm not happy. And possibly you're not happy with it either. So I say, I'm not happy. And you say, I'm not happy either. Our first alternative, I'm not happy either. And again, all you do is you copy the original statement exactly as it is and add the word either. I'm not happy either. The second alternative is me neither. Me neither. So the words neither and either are used to show your agreement to a negative statement. All right. So now let's look at the third alternative. I'm happy. So am I. So am I. If this original statement is positive, we use the word so, and then we copy the auxiliary, the helping verb from the original statement, and that is am. So am I. Now, if you noticed, this is like a question order, question word order. Normally we say I am. If it's in a question form, it becomes am I. So you use the question word order. So am I. Not I am, but so am I. It might feel a little bit strange at the beginning, but you will find that you get used to it very quickly. So am I. I'm happy. So am I. How about when it's negative? I'm not happy because it's a very busy road. Neither am I. Neither am I. So this is very similar to this, but because it is a negative statement, because I'm agreeing to a negative statement, this is a negative statement, I use the word neither. Neither am I. And again, I use the same auxiliary from the original. Okay, now time to look at some sentences and practice. Okay, here we have some sentences and let's see how we can use the form neither am I, so am I, so and neither. The first one, this one is easy, I think, because it's very similar to the first example that we looked at. I am bored. So if your friend tells you this and you feel bored, how would you show your agreement? I am bored. So am I. So am I. I copied the auxiliary am, and because it is a positive sentence, I use the word so. Now you might be thinking, boredom, being bored, is nothing positive. Yes, I agree, but grammatically this sentence is positive, and we look at it grammatically. I am bored because I don't use the word not. This is a positive sentence. I am bored, so am I. Okay, let's look at the second one. Number two. I need a drink. Hot day. It's a hot day, or I've been talking for some time. So, I need a drink. You feel you need a drink as well. What would you say? I need a drink. So do I. So what happened here? Where did the word do come from? We said that we copy, in the middle we copy the auxiliary, the helping verb. Do is the auxiliary verb of this sentence, but we can't actually see it there, but it is a do sentence. I need a drink. Now, if you're not sure what the auxiliary is or if it's not in the sentence, here's a trick that you can perhaps use. Use the same statement in a question form. So try to make it a question. And because you have to use the auxiliary, it'll probably tell you the word that you're after. I need a drink. Do you need a drink? Do you need a drink? Do. Yes, I do. Yes, I need a drink. So the auxiliary is do. So do I. I need a drink, so do I. I'm very thirsty. Okay, the third example. I have been working very hard. I could do with a break. It means I need a break. I could do with a break. You've been working very hard as well, and you want a break. So what would you say? I could do with a break. So could I. Then, because it is a positive sentence, I use the word so, and I copy the auxiliary could, so could I, so could I, in the question word order. Could I, not I could, so could I. All right, number four. I haven't done my homework. I've been very busy, so I haven't done my homework. What would you say? I haven't done my homework. Neither have I. Why? This is a negative statement. Now we're showing our agreement to a negative statement. So I have to use neither, not so, neither. And the auxiliary that I have here, the helping verb, is have. I haven't done my homework. Neither have I. Neither have I. All right. Okay. Number five. I can sing. I can sing. So can I. It's a positive statement. I can sing. So I use the word so. So can I. I can sing. I'm not very good at it though. And you want to say that you're not good at singing either. How can you say it? I can sing. I'm not very good at it though. Neither am I. It means I can sing and I'm not good at singing either. Neither am I. I'm not very good at it. Neither am I. Okay, number seven. The lunch was delicious. I have eaten too much though. I have eaten too much. You have eaten too much. So you say, so have I. I have eaten too much, so have I. Positive, have. In present perfect tense, I have eaten too much. Okay, and the last one. I have eaten too much, and now I have tummy ache, stomach ache. I wish I had stopped myself. I wish I had stopped myself. Then I wouldn't have had stomachache. So what would you say? I wish I had stopped myself. And you are in the same situation, so you want to show your agreement that you wish you had stopped yourself. So you say, so do I. Oh, did it all with blue. So do I. Now you might be thinking, but there is past perfect here, etc. But you know that it is at the end of the sentence. The real statement here is I wish. And you want to say, I wish I had stopped myself too. So I wish is what you focus on. And wish is a do sentence. I do wish. Do you wish? Do you wish to continue on the computers? You always say, do you wish to continue? I wish I had stopped myself. So do I. Okay, that's it from me for today. I hope you found the video useful. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up, and I will see you in my next lesson.